That's the thing, though, right? Like, the Orianna Jarvan comes in now, and Rogue have all the tools they need to keep that,
Ooh, if he goes into Zanzar, it could be rough.
Look at this. Already getting exhaust. He's getting a little bit of damage back on Checkalight, who didn't have enough mana, but Clockwork Windup does a lot when you're able to wail away and get the knock-up on the flash to Tinks. He gets a heal and first blood for Vatheo. Zanzara, he thought he had the play, but Tinks was confident with this.
To be able to counter gank that one right there. And, you know, he commits for the Flash Warden, that's fine. But then, with both supports roaming up there, didn't realize what was happening. Now, but he has bot lane.
And Woolite, there is no real fight back there. He realized the moment he saw Vatheo, see it. I'm out of this one. I'm just going to see if I can at least get a little.
We're going to take a lot of. Look at this flank, though, from Tinks. He's cosplaying a wolf.
I like this from the side of Vando, looking for the pick on a Shigenda, thinking that he's not tanking enough. Going to get the call of the forge, got a lot of damage. Is he going to be able to get the knockup? He's not going to be able to. He has to get out of there.
Rogue, for the time being, Xanth can, of course, scout here. Should cancel that one coming through, but only sees the yellow star. Now Vatheo's jumping on him.
A little bit of poke, trying to see if he can get over the wall. Will be able to, but look at the flip over the wall. Killing spree from Vatheo, getting away from Woolite as well. No jungle, you know.
Yeah, so LDLC are playing for the wave control first because they have Baron, it's hard, but here we go.
Look at the engage into the backline. It locked in Hades, but nobody else is able to collapse into the backline. Vatheo's going to be able to get onto Woolite. Look at the damage comes in. He's trying to get that final execution. Going to be able to get the kill onto Shekulad. Everyone's trying to disengage from that Akali, but they just can't. They can't do it. They all are starting to fall. Shigenda in the middle of everybody, and they're chased down by Bando. Tinks already got his double kill. Looking for the triple kill onto Woolite underneath the turret. He gets it. LDLC find the fight that they need, and they're looking like they're at the precipice of victory.
Baron's going to be coming up in 2 minutes, so unless Rogue full commit in towards a fight, we're not going to see the game end now, but they're going in.
You see that two members are on the bottom side of the map. They think that this is their time to be able to get the fight, but Zanzara takes way too damage. They're going to be able to jump in onto Hades, but nobody's able to collapse. He turns around the kill onto the tank, gets rid of him. Now Shigenda, he's the only one left around to win the world, and you can see in the backline, they've taken out Woolite. Going to be able to get the shockwave only onto one Mystique. Double kill for Vatheo. Shigenda the next to fall in the fight. He knows it's all over. Hades is on a killing spree. They even flash forward to knock back Checkalad and try to get the kill over to Vatheo, but he will be able to nearly escape, but it does not matter. It is the LFL at victory, wanting to get back to the finals. They made it last spring. They're doing it this one.
LDLC are just too damn strong, charging in towards the base here, making sure they can finish things off in style. Tinks untouchable throughout this series, and France is going to the finals.
They will. It will be LDLC's first time at it. They're going to be happy with that victory. They found the picks. They want to pad the KDA one more time. But Viva!